Okay, so this is new. So if you guys do want coins and want the best players in the game for the cheapest coins on the market, make sure to go to u7buy.com and use a discount code VIZZA for 5% off your total order. If you don't use your discount code, then have a cry. So enjoy the video.
You either got a shoe from here, here, or out here. If you shoot from here or here, it is a genuine fucking lottery as to whether or not your shot will go on target or not.
It's mind-blowing, and I hope these people don't get to the live events, because no one is watching the live events then anymore. And yeah, so this is basically what I experienced, and I hope EA will fix something about high pressure or something. I don't know. This has to be fixed, man. Really. I'm done. I'm really done.
Everything, and I think it made me realize two different things, right? One thing with this game, it's not good enough to be in a competitive state. Because there are people that have joined this Discord, was a dodging Discord. This is a North American dodging Discord with seeking to be Elite 2 plus players that are trying to be competitive or professional players.
He just shot that at my keeper. Look. Look! Look! But don't get mad! Don't get mad to lose to a drop back one depth player that scores that goal with 78% pass accuracy and 39% possession. But I'm not supposed to get mad.
All these Pep Guardiola wannabes, oh, because they wanted a slow and realistic game. You enjoying it now, you bums? Keeping 80% of the possession? Oh, look at me! I'm so good! I can keep the ball for 5 out of the 6 half minutes! I'm so good! That takes so much skill! Where is the skill gap?
FIFA 20 is in serious, serious danger. Now, you guys may think that I'm going insane and I'm doing the same video over and over again. I assure you I'm not here. Each weekend, there's brand new things going on, which is absolutely insane, which I can't play the game properly the same way that I want to. I got gold 3, I got like 14 and 3 losses. I didn't even do bad at all. I had a good weekend league. I had a very good weekend league. And it's honestly mind-boggling, because when we play FIFA, it's like a normal, you know, okay, good or decent competitive level. But when you reach the pro level scene, worst game to ever play. And honestly, I'm even touching gold that this is even worse than last year on a basic fun level. Not saying that this is not more of a football game. This is a much more bigger football game. But my word, they are really like splitting the line here between fun and realism, and they are so far to one side here, it's actually insane. This tweet that you see right here is a pro player who played in the qualifiers. So basically, for example, if you don't know, to qualify to one of these your main live events, you play qualifiers in a Swiss bracket, i.e. you, like, let's say you play like 6-7 games. If you win 4, then you go through. If you lose 4, then you go out. So like basically you're 4-3 or whatever. And simply you're playing some of the pros and you win and you lose or whatever happens, you happens. And in this event, for example, here they played against a guy with 95% possession. This is what you're seeing in pro games. You're seeing people do this. Look at his gameplay. The guy's in yellow, the guy that's just time wasting, right? And just passing the ball. Look at this. Pass, pass, back, pass, back, split, pass, back. And literally, it's all a case of one person in drop back and one person too much of a pussy to do anything else. And look at it, it's still along the back. And the worst part is, if you play Division 3 onwards or upwards, it's kind of similar to this. It's kind of similar to the gameplay where one person can barely defend, therefore they go drop back. And if a person, when they try and attack, they know that it's so hard to make any risky balls or any passes, or they can't even dribble the ball, then they just pass it around and just wait for the most obvious gap to do anything. It's honestly so boring. For me, the FIFA esports scene, or FIFA 20, is in serious danger. So let's get into the good things and then get into the bad things, because there is a brand new patch to talk about, a brand new pitch notes which goes into some brand new things which hopefully would help people in the game. But from what we've seen, it kind of looks like the same thing all over again. So let's get into good things, right? So career mode looks like it's all back to normal. Only a few issues to do with the likes of teams went from not using their main players and then being terrible to now maybe being a bit too OP. I saw a tweet by a guy that had Barcelona like win 36 games and only draw 2 the entire season. So they only drew 2 games the entire season. did not lose a single one, and they won every single game with Barcelona in a La Liga and a Quimble save. It's a bit too overpowered, I think, now, but you know what? I'd rather have it too overpowered than not good enough. So that's just, you know, it's, there are a few more tweaks in there, but Quimble as of right now is pretty much back to normal, which is great. Pro Clubs, do you think EA cares about Pro Clubs? Do you think EA cares about that? Do they? No, they don't. So let's get into the main thing, which most of you guys care about, which is Ultimate Team. So what's new here? What's changed here? What's good? What's bad? Well, one good thing is the fact that Weekend League is over. So that's the main good thing here. Bad thing is that Weekend League is still here next week. So Weekend League, in my honest opinion, I think is completely flawed. If you're my level, it's completely fine. But if we're on about an entire esport here, the entire reason why FIFA 20 has been changed the way it is to appeal to the competitive scene, is to make it a competitive game, and therefore make you want to go and spend money on packs and then get these good teams and then compete in the game. That's how it's completely based on. However, when you actually go into the pro scene, there's so many issues, it's actually insane. This is a tweet by Footwiz Dan, a well-known guy in the FIFA community, one of the co-founders of Footwiz, which is, as you probably should know, is a well-known team in the FIFA scene. And he said this: so default loss given to someone who proved his opponent's connection was at fault. Second leg of the game, scores 3-1. Restarted the game due to complete 0-0 due to a rule break by the player that was losing the game, and it was his fault. And so they went from 3-1 and it changed the game back to 0-0 because of the opponent that was losing the game. And then there's also another player who is currently 2-0 in the thing, but he's got a ban right now. So there's people playing which should be given bans with a player right now. I don't care if you're the worst person in the world or you're a nice person, no one deserves to be, you know, kind of cheated out of the events here. And you may think, oh, it's just FIFA, it doesn't really matter. These pros, this is their potential livelihoods. A lot is on the line here. I don't think you understand how much money these pro players put into the game on FIFA points, because they can't get coins any other way, to then hope that they can make a team that's good enough to actually compete in these kind of events. It's all based on how much money you put in, therefore the better team you get, therefore the more chance you actually have to actually do well. Because guess what? The difference between Jadon Sancho compared to a Mane is unreal. Let's say I'll give a good player like a Dembele, Ousmane Dembele. Trying to compare an Ousmane Dembele to like a Neymar is, again, next level. Trying to compare a good player like a Lenglet to, let's say, a Van Dijk is, again, insane. Like, there's so much difference between these players that they're increasing the difference between the lower tier players to the higher tier players. A Rashford compared to a Mbappe is completely, it's not even comparable at times. Mbappe's pace is a lot better, his shooting is so much better, his dribbling, his movement speed, everything is so much better, that if you have these players, you literally have got such an advantage, and you are trying your absolute best to lose a game if you do not end up winning most of your games. And you know what? I want you guys to tell me down below in the comments, what is your genuine opinions? Now, people who, I was saying on day one, saying that, you know what, this game is not a bad game, however, it's not a fun game, and people are calling me crazy in the first day or two, thinking, oh, you're just terrible at the game, blah, 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 blah. Please tell me, has your opinion changed on the game recently? I'm not here to argue, guys. You guys can think I'm crazy, you guys can think that I'm never happy. How can I be happy when I'm seeing more and more people get more frustrated about the game because EA seems to be completely ignoring what people actually want? And that takes me on to my next point. Next up is the fact that there's a new pitch notes, yay, new patch. Yes, we can have maybe some hope, maybe to change something. Not a single thing is in there about player changing, about servers, about delay. Not a single thing is changed about the actual servers, because this is the main issue. The gameplay can be fun, but it changes the gameplay dependent on what time you play it. Tell me any game that makes any sense. Fortnite, you go to each game should act the same way. When you click right click to shoot, it should shoot boom, 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 consistently each time. Every single time, it should be consistent. The amount of times that I went to go press A to pass the ball, you know what, I'll show you Crassy's tweet. So this is Crassy. You probably would know of him if you've seen him on YouTube. He does tutorials, things like that, and he's I don't think he's a pro, like he's done some events before in the past, but like he's, you know, on and off, and he's in a video here showing his controller and what he's pressing, and you can see that he presses it, he puts power into it, and the game doesn't allow the pass to be made. So pass A, pass backwards, and also move backwards, put power into it, and again, just make it.
Can you pass it? Nah, come on!
Next up, simple, through ball, down wide.
Pass!
Doesn't do it. Next up, to do a straight pass straight away, first time pass, and
passing the ball in 3 seconds.
Again, there's a through ball, doesn't work. Passes to side, upwards, and...
Nah, he's not passing the ball! How to play with that gameplay, EA?
And again, another pass, and again, doesn't take a pass. Nope.
Pass! Unplayable.
And that is a simple 45-second clip about the delay of the game and how it actually looks like. Now, the amount of times that I've played this game and people think that's all my head, that I say I press A to pass or a through ball or I meant to shoot and it doesn't actually shoot, and people saying, oh wait, what do you mean? It's on your head. It's not in my head. This is legitimate proof that gameplay is terrible if you play at peak times, specifically for foot champions and so on. Because you guys have been saying to me for a long time, saying, oh, why do you play the game? You know, why do you play the game if you keep complaining about it? If Burnley loses their next game, or loses 10 games in a row, am I supposed to not complain about it? Or am I supposed to just give it up and just go support a new team? You know, people say, oh, don't play FIFA, you know, if you don't like it, just go stop it, play a different game. If I'm supposed to be passionate about a game, like I am about FIFA, about my job, and I'm also passionate about Burnley, my football team, am I supposed to, like, not keep that passion and want to see that for the best? I want to see the best that it could possibly be? Am I just supposed to just give up? I make videos because I know so many people that's driving themselves insane, thinking, is it just me? Is it just me? And I'm here to tell you that it's not just you that's thinking this way. The amount of pro players that I've seen drive themselves insane this weekend is absolutely insane. All I can say is that FaZe Tass, a well-known, long, prevalent person in the pro scene, is saying things like this. And it's not the same as Kurt, it's huge gorilla. It's so many pros that's driving himself over the wall, man. It's actually insane. And also, how can I forget about Run the Foot Market? Run the Foot Market got stream sniped by pros and got cheated out of top 100 for just getting a DC. Well, his opponent getting a DC, I believe. But he also found a massive thing about pro players dodging each other. All the North America players dodging each other, and it's an absolute joke about how these pro players are not just dealing with this absolute pile of, I don't even know, game. And they're now going to Discord and dodging each other and doing absolutely everything they can to sly ways here and there. And you know what? It's been a week and I've not even heard anything from EA about it. You know what? Go back and play FIFA 16. Go grab a non-rare. Go grab Dabble from back in FIFA 16. Go grab any non-rare gold. I guarantee they'll feel probably the same to what my Insigne, my Dembele, and my Allen, and my Mertens feels now. I guarantee they feel similar now. So tell me down below in the comments, what's your thoughts? Are you changing your opinion on this game? Are you just playing career mode? Are you just trading? You know what? I've been having so much fun trading. I've been having so much fun trading and sniping. I love it, making coins. And you know what? I may just do that. My second channel is down below in the description as well. There'll be some vlogs over there of my real life. So keep an eye on that. And yeah, that's thanks for watching. My name is Fizz. I'll see you next time.